Hi, Trader. Tina here once again from ShortMeTina.com with my daily recap. So we're going to kick it off as usual with a recap of the overall markets. But before I get there, if this is your very first time listening to a ShortMeTina video, do us a solid in the comments section. Just say hello. Let us know this is your first time. You can let me also know whether or not you agreed or disagreed with my analysis and if you're in any of the trades that I mentioned. If you're tuned in and you're a recurring listener, I want to say, as you know, thanks from the bottom of my heart. It's very appreciative. I appreciate the fact that you tune in every single day or you tune in often to listen. So with the SPY, we had a bit of a sell-off today with confirming volume closed at 291.16 went as high as 295.23. Good. Remember what I said? I feel that we need to have a pullback for this market to continue going higher, because we've rallied, I want to say, about 25%, if not more, from December lows. So I'd like for us to pull back to this breakout base here of around 280 to 282, once resistance, now support, just to kind of see the strength of the bulls, right? Once the stock or the ETF in this particular situation gravitates towards that breakout base, can we hold that? I suspect that we will, but for me to know that, I want us to retest that. So going into tomorrow and the remainder of the week, let's pay attention to today's low of 290.80. I'm sure the market, it'll do either two things. It's going to open up and then we're going to break that low, or it's going to try to at best retest today's high of 295.23 before pulling back. At any rate, it's looking like it might be a good short time short, right? I really think the market is going to at some point hit 315 to 316, potentially even 320. I see it in the 300s, you know, heading into the summer towards the ending of the year, but I still think you might be able to get another, you might be able to make a good 3 to 5% on a slight pullback here. So that's what I'm going to be paying attention to. What else? IWM daily chart. As usual, I'm paying attention to that 160 mark. We have not been able to get above that since going all the way back to October, which is about 6 months or so, maybe even a little bit more at this point. So again, resistance clocks in at 158 to 160. Nasty candle confirming volume closed at 156.36. Went as high as slightly under 159. So we, once again, have not been able to penetrate that 160 line. And so I'm going to be paying attention to that again. As with the SPY, I think in the shorter term, you might be looking at a decent shorting opportunity. What else? So Zynga daily chart reported earnings today after hours. Huge move in after hours. I think we went as high as 620. So I've done several videos on Zynga before. So full disclaimer, full disclosure, we did go long Zynga in the premium member community when the stock was trading in the low to mid three. So we're close to achieving a double here. And so I actually held during earnings, right? I don't always hold my position during earnings, but when you've established a good cushion and when you're looking at a really strong chart, I wouldn't say it's a gamble. It's very much so a calculated risk. But again, with a buy zone of low to mid threes, you really have a cushion. So even if the stock sold off 10, 15%, you're still in profit. Hence why I decided to hold into earnings. And so I definitely let go of some, but I'm still holding a portion of my position and I'm going to add to that position. Why? Well, just look at the chart. This is stuff like dreams are made of, in my opinion. So this chart goes back to essentially when the stock IPO'd in 2011. We're definitely on the verge of breaking out. We have not seen these highs that we made in after hours today dating back to 2014. So that's 5 years in the making. So right now we're running into resistance. Obviously, I'm expecting a pullback, but considering we are well above that channel or that breakout area from 2017, this blue line here, I suspect, right, again, we'll probably pull back, but I do believe the stock will eventually, again, surpass this 6 to 620 resistance level and potentially go on to around $8. That's not around the corner. That's something that's going to take some time to unfold. But again, when you're sitting in a profit, hold it. And in my opinion, Zynga is a hold. It's a stock that everyone should have in their portfolio at this point. What else? And then we have ticker BPMX daily chart. I haven't done a video on this stock since I believe the day that the company issued its reverse stock split. So sitting here at 126, we're kind of at 5 cents. And if you go back to the videos that I did 2, 3, 4 months ago, I said more than likely BPMX will retest the December lows of 5 cents. And essentially it did that today. In fact, it went lower, going as low as 112. But if you do the calculations, that would be equivalent to about 4 cents prior to this reverse split. So not only did we retest the December lows, but we actually went lower. So in my opinion, obviously BPMX is not a buy. You want to stay away from stocks that are trading at literally all-time lows, especially if the stock has been trading on the exchange for a while. You want to stay away from stocks that are non-compliant. You want to stay away from stocks that are at risk of getting delisted. You want to stay away from stocks that have to do a reverse split to stay actually on the board. Now, I know that is hard for a lot of folks that may have bought the stock when it was at 50, 60, but you know what? Go listen to any one of my videos and you'll hear that at some point on my trading journey, I had to book that crazy monumental like loss. I'm talking $30,000, $40,000, $50,000, because I used to play in this kind of arena. It's not to say that I don't trade these types of stocks, but I do it in a very systematic, disciplined, and structured way. Definitely, I'm not looking at these stocks as a golden ticket in any sense. But so for BPMX, still bearish, I would stay away at this point. Look, confirming volume. People are just unloading everyone. The story is essentially over. You might get your dead cat bounces. You might get your pops. But overall, I'd stay away. What else? And then we have Blue Apron, ticker APRN daily chart, up north of 2% on the day, closed at 105. So I've done several videos on Blue Apron. And if you look at the chart, obviously going back further, but if we can just start here, August of 2018, approaching a year, for the most part, $1 has held. Granted, we'd had like little dips here and there, but quickly rebounded to reclaim that $1 mark, with the exception of December when all stocks were just in a complete free fall. So for me, that indicates for Blue Apron, $1, you know, and it could be 95 cents, 96, but in that $1 area, that is representative of support that has held overall, with the exception of December, since August of 2018. So if you're looking to go long, or if you're looking to get into this trade, getting in as close as getting in around that dollar mark or as close to a dollar as possible makes sense from a risk reward perspective. If it can stay above a dollar, I can see this going to $1.50. So about 50% of upside really here sitting at $1.05 for Blue Apron. What else? And then we have ticker NOVN daily chart. So I did a video on this yesterday. I said everyone should put it on their watch list. Pay attention to pre-market. That would have been an indicator as to whether or not the stock had more oomph left in it, for lack of a better way of framing it or phrasing it. So I was paying attention to this pre-market. Pre-market didn't start out well. We were actually losing ground in pre-market, and then we opened, right? We opened at 130, which was below yesterday's close of 149. So completely off to a bad start in pre-market when the market actually opened. And so we ended up shedding about 20% on the day. Closed at 120. The low of the day was 118. And you know what I normally say, if a stock closes relatively close to the low of the day, chances are that selling will continue into the next trading day or that trading week. So I'm not expecting great things from ticker NOVN going into tomorrow. I will not throw the stock out yet. It's still a stock to be watched. This can be a pullback gearing up for another run. But at this point, remain on the sidelines. I'm on the sidelines, but I will continue to watch. What else? And then we have ticker FIT daily chart up about 1.7% on the day. We're up in after hours. The last quote I saw was 548. Fitbit has been trading within a channel dating back to 2016. You guys know how I like to trade. You can call them channels. You can call them range. You can call them accumulation. You can call it distribution, whatever. 2 points, support, resistance. If you want to know how to trade a channel, I'm going to link it somewhere there. Make sure to watch that video. So for me, would I put Fitbit on my radar? Potentially, it's a trade. It's not a high quality trade, right? Because if you look at the longer term chart, the stock is actually trading it's been in a decline. Granted, we've been trading in a range for about 2 years, but overall it's been in a decline. So is it a high quality stock? No. But is there a trade to be had? Yes. At this point, no. I would wait until it got to the lower end of that range, which we can call support of around 450, and then I'd go long there. So you're asking yourself, well, Tina, what if it goes to 575 tomorrow? Are you trading it? No. What if it goes to $5? Are you trading it? No. What if it gets to 475? Are you buying it? No. I will trade it once it gets to support. What else? And then we have ticker NIO daily chart off about 3.5% on the day. You know, I like to trade my channel and my ranges. They're very easy and, in my opinion, hugely reliable. Again, I'm going to link how to trade a channel or how I trade channels somewhere in this video. So check that out. So again, NIO daily chart dating back to September when the stock IPO'd. Trading within a channel, trading within a range. We tried to go long here, got stopped out. Tried to buy at support. It doesn't always work. Tried to buy at support around here, got stopped out. Support broke. Went as low as 443, bounced a little bit, closed at 468. So for me, all eyes, hence why that arrow is there, will be on the low of 443. Ideally, again, I would like for the stock to retest that lows just to measure the strength of the bulls and the bears, right? Will the stock hit that low and bounce? Or will it crater some more? So that's what I'm holding out for. That's what I'm paying attention to because I would like to get into ticker NIO. But it has to be, from a risk-reward perspective, it has to make sense. So I know a lot of folks, I talk about being disciplined and all this other stuff. And folks are probably wondering like, wow, how can you have so much resolve that you can actually sit and wait for these trades to set up? And my answer to that is, well, again, I've been trading for over 15 years and it wasn't something that happened overnight. I think for me, what really did it is losing all the time. Like, if you're going to be in the stock market, unless you have money just kind of like coming out the wazoo, you get to a point, especially if you really want to remain in the game, you get to a point where you say to yourself, well, what am I doing? Am I just, you know, throwing money away? Or do I really want to learn the markets? And for me, again, I'm so disciplined because I lost so much in the beginning and I no longer want to lose if it's not necessary. And so I always place myself in the most optimal position for maximum profit. That means passing on a lot of trades. There's a lot of trades that I may have missed the entry by pennies. Sometimes by 1 or 2 cents, and I see it go on to rally. In fact, in ticker NIO, I want to say we missed our entry right around here, right? And then I saw the stock gap up and go. Did I chase it? No, I waited. The trade didn't work out. But I say that to say, and this is just a very simple example, I've seen stocks, you know, go in my favor, like double. I remember, well, that's neither here nor there, a particular stock, but I've seen stocks appreciate 30, 40, 50, sometimes 100% when I've missed my entry by a few points. And, you know, it's some, those are just the things that you have to live with, or I choose to live with because I lost so much in the past. Like, you know, it's that person that gets burned time and time again. And for the past, I can babble about that. This is not a podcast. This is just technical analysis. So to recap, NIO, I'm paying attention to the most recent low of 443 to measure the strength of both the bears and the bulls. And I'll make my decision whether or not I will get into this trade. What else? And then we have ticker ABIO up nicely on the day, closed at 1025. So went as high as 1288, pulled back. So, you know, similar to NOVN, what you want to be paying attention to is what happens in pre-market. If we open up above the high, that's a good cue that the stock is ready to run. If we open up below the close, then chances are it's going to be a sell-off. What else? And so let's round it out with ticker WFT off about 22% on the day, closed at 42 cents. So I've done several videos on ticker WFT, and I indicated as long as it can stay above, I think that mark was around 60 cents, we should be okay. And you can see, like, when a stock craves or caves below an important level, you get stuff like this. Look at this candle, because more or less, folk stops are being triggered and people are just generally getting out because for the most part, everyone is looking at the same support lines. So for ticker WFT, breach support, selling got underway off about 22% on the day with confirming volume. We closed relatively close to the low of the day. The low of the day clocked in at around 42 cents. So for me, stay away. Might be more selling underway. I see this taking a trip to the low of around 23 cents. Hence why I do not like trading penny stocks. They're not very reliable. You can get that 20, 30, 40% sell off in a blink of an eye. And generally speaking, more often than not, the stocks don't rebound. They just continue to drift lower. So that's my take on ticker WFT. Expect more selling. Do not be surprised to see it revisit December lows of around 25 cents. So let's cap it there. Tina, once again, from ShortMeTina.com. If you enjoyed any portion of this video, I'd like for you to do three things for me. One, comment in the comment section. Do you agree with me? Not everyone does. Are you in any of the trades that I spoke about? Let me know. That's the first thing. Second thing is, if you want more videos like this, head on over to our YouTube channel at ShortMeTina. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications. I think we're about 8 subscribers away from that 1,000 mark. So if you're not subscribed, and I generally get about 300 views per video. So if you're not 300 views, that means 300 people are listening to this. And if you're not subscribed, can you be that 8 that gets me to 1,000 or over 1,000? Greatly appreciated to kick off the month of May. And the reason why you should also subscribe, I forgot that part, outside of my begging. The reason that you should subscribe is because I do videos Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. And, you know, there's nuggets of information there. Again, I've been training for a long time, which leads me to reason number 3. If you want more value, if you think I can provide you with value, I've been trading for over 15 years, then head on over to ShortMeTina.com. Sign up, become a member. Thank you for listening. Start again. It's a nice day for a white wedding. It's a nice day to start again. Hey little sister, who is it you're with?